Hello, welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to talk about a subject that might be a little bit surprising to some of you, and is that the movement for the independence of Catalonia, sometimes we say, and I have said it as well, that we are pro-independence, but we are not nationalist. Is this possible? To see this, maybe we can see what the specialized studies in social science says about it. And they say every movement for the independence or for the decolonizations are by definition nationalist. But these specialized studies says more. They said in the construction of every nation, of every state, there would be nationalism. And in the continuity of the states, there is nationalism, with the majority of the society being nationalist. So if almost everybody is nationalist, why most of the people don't feel like? This is because the most common nationalism, which is the state's nationalism, is a banal nationalism in the sense that it's quite invisible. It's everywhere, but it doesn't have to explain itself or make like campaign, because there is no need. It's in the shape of everybody's mind in this society. And also, the structures of the state, they protect the nation. So then the citizen doesn't feel that he has to dedicate energies to the nation, be an activist in nationalism. So people dedicate energies to other things in the private life, and then they don't feel nationalist. But this nationalism can emerge when there is a threat to the nation. And this is what happened in Spain when the movement for the independence of Catalonia said that they will try to do a referendum on self-determination of Catalonia. Then many Spanish people that didn't feel nationalist, they had to stand up and say this is not possible, and then they reacted. And they were quite angry, because for them this is a solved problem. Catalonia has to remain in Spain, whatever and regardless what the Catalan feel or think. So this is quite a nationalistic way of thinking. But this is not only for the intense nationalist political parties like Vox, or Popular Party or Ciudadans, but also the Spanish Socialist Party rejected this referendum so strongly. And even Podemos on the left, a political party that accepted the referendum as a means to solve the problem, but they didn't say do the referendum and we don't mind the result. They said in this case we would make a campaign for the no, and we would try the Catalan people to remain in Spain. So in this way they showed they were nationalist, but in this case in a democratic way, which is good. But how can we demonstrate that the movement for the independence of Catalonia is nationalist? We can see it in two ways, and in these two ways we are going to learn also some things about this movement. First of all, the idea of making a process of independence to make another state, it answers a lot to the kind of nationalism that is in Catalonia, because Catalan nationalism is not offensive or aggressive. It's a defensive and an intransigent movement to try to keep the way of looking at life from Catalan people, because they are we are in touch with other nationalism which are very strong and very dominant. So we think that Spain in this way is a state made by the Spanish nationalism, with one view, one language, Spanish, and one capital, Madrid, with everything centralized in it. But of course, after Franco, because of the differences in the Catalan and the Basque and the Galician regions, they had to have this in consideration, so they made, instead of a confederal state, they made a lot of autonomies and a system of autonomies with a little bit of decentralization. And now we can learn Catalan in school, use Catalan in media, we have Catalan institutions, and we have some kind of decentralization. But some people say, hey, Catalan people, you have more than other nations without the state, so why are you complaining? Spain is treating you quite well. But this is not like this, because this situation is not because of a plurinational approach to Spain. with a lot of nations that treat themselves as same level, and they give one to each other what they need to develop. It's not like this. It was because for some time there was some Catalan votes needed to make majorities in the Spanish parliament in Madrid. So from this way we could get some rights, but these rights could go backwards. Like, we have the Catalan school with Catalan language and Spanish language. Catalan language was forbidden for a long time, and it was diminishing, so it was about to disappear, but now it's not, because of this school is making it go up. And also we learn in Spanish, and we have the same level as other places in Spain. So this school is working, and it's working for both languages. So why the Spanish nationalism is always complaining, saying that we should teach less in Catalan and we should teach more in Spanish? And also, for instance, if we want our language, Catalan, spoken by 10 million people, to be in the European institutions, no way, because from Spain they always say this is not possible, you have to speak there only Spanish. So in this case we can see that the independence process is to get some strategy of surviving for the Catalan nation. So there is a nation, there is nationalism. And also we can see another very important characteristic of the movement for the independence of Catalonia, which is anti-Francoism, anti-fascism. And we can compare it to other regions in Spain, which are also anti-Francoist. Because we see that in Germany there was Hitler, and Hitler was defeated, so they could clean all the German state. But in Spain, Franco was not defeated. Francoists, they voluntarily went into democracy, so they kept some power. And there is a lot of Francoism in the monarchy, in the justice, in the army, in the police, in the political parties and enterprises. So we see that there is a lot of Francoism in Spain, still values, ways of doing, and the conception of the state. So for a long time we have been trying to make Spain more democratic, more plurinational, but once we see that because of this Francoism it's not going to be possible, we can imagine ourselves out of the Spain, because we have this nation frame in our head, so we have nationalism again. Also, if we compare to other regions, maybe they are also Francoist, anti-Francoist as well, but they can only try to make Spain better, because they cannot imagine themselves like apart from Spain, because they would be apart from their natural nation. And this is very clear in this time as well, no? So why people from the movement for the independence of Catalonia want to get apart from nationalism? Well, first of all, because nationalism has a bad negative connotation. But also because some people from left, we see that maybe nationalism has to do with right wing, and not at all, because of course there is right wing nationalism, but there is also left wing nationalism, as Fidel Castro or Nelson Mandela prove. So Catalan independentist movement is right and left both, but there is more people on the left. This is shown by the statistics. And also, sometimes we don't want to be associated with nationalism, because we see that nationalism is like identitarian movement, and we are not, because we have a very plural society. We have more than 300 languages in Catalonia. It's not Catalan and Spanish. There is people coming from other places, and we have people, Catalan people, that has multiple identities, and there is not a problem for them with that, no? So we have to respect that. And as a society, we go to a very inclusive society. We have to make intercultural dialogue. We have to be empathic. And this is the way in which we cannot get static with our own identity, with homogeneous identity. No, there is many other people. So we are making this process that makes us better, I think, because it's the way in which the world is also going. So in this way, we can see who is considered Catalan. Is considered Catalan who lives in Catalonia, works in Catalonia, and loves Catalonia. So anyone coming from abroad could be immediately Catalan with fulfilling these three characteristics. And you can see that in the statistics. You can cross statesmen in favor or against immigration with the vote of the people. And you can see that Catalan people voting for independentist political parties, they are more inclusive to immigration, and Catalan people voting for unionist options would be a little bit less inclusive with immigration. So in conclusion, we can say that if someone is pointing to the movement for the independence of Catalonia saying that we are nationalist, yes, we are, but the one pointing it's also. And then we have to see which adjective go with these nationalisms to see whether it's good or not. And in summary, the movement for the independence of Catalonia is not identitarian. We have an identity, we have a Catalan language, and we can have a nation that we can see that it's possible to do an independence process. But we are not identitarian, not on the right. We are all right and left, but mostly in the left. And it's a civic project with a Republican idea and with all the adjectives I told you in this video. So if this attracts Catalan people, this movement will go ahead and it will look for how to do. And if this movement doesn't attract people, Catalan people, then it will go back, you know. And we will see that in the future. So if you like this video, we can see in the next one. Bye-bye.